Abraham Ijirani, spokesman of the Sultanate of SULU, labels as black propaganda reports from Malaysia that the offensive this morning resulted in what Malaysia calls their total defeat. Ijirani maintains their forces, led by Raja Muda Agbimuddin Kiram, are, in his words, alive and kicking. Princess Jaycel Kiram also read a letter from her father, Sultan Jamalul Kiram, during a press conference from their home in Taguig. Here's that message.
Now, as the battle rages under a tremendous and superior force by the Malaysian composite forces of Air Force and naval bombardment, including Army and Police Force, all we could do is to ask the Almighty Allah to protect our people in Lahad Datu, Sampurna, Kunak, Sandakan, and all over the island of Sabah. Raja Muda Agbimuddin Kiram, encouraged by his aspiration, together with the 214 members of the Royal Security Force, to reclaim and settle peacefully in our homeland. The Crown Prince, the Royal Security Force, and the many patriots who landed voluntarily will fight to the last man, protecting the ideals and aspirations. It is quite suspicious that this came after Pinoy has delivered his message yesterday at 4 p.m. The tactical statements of Pinoy and the Malaysian statement are full of hypothetical speculations and analogies, which are setting a predicate for the people to be confused and divert their attention on the real issue, on how our government mishandled the crisis, showing their insensitive attitude towards the Sultanate of SULU and the Muslim sentiments, as if we are not Filipinos. Question: is it now clear that the government of Pinoy has given up and now pursues where to put the blame on the basis of imaginary conspiracies? Mr. President, wala pong nagsulsol, wala pong financier, at wala pong mga foreign interest na nakikialam sa ginagawa ng Sultanate of SULU. Mr. President, hanggang naninindigan si Sultan Jamalul Kiram III at si Raja Muda Agbimuddin sa kanilang paniniwala na ipagtanggol ang kanilang karapatan sa North Borneo, Sabah, please, please, do not disrespect the integrity of their intentions. Mr. President, you cannot wash your hands by turning your back on your own people. Hindi na nga po kayo nakatulong. Ipakukulong pa ninyo ang mga nagsakripisyo ng buhay para sa kanilang karapatan, para makuha ang kanilang pag-aari at patrimonya ng bansang Pilipinas. Let the people and the nation judge you for this act. Mr. President, you must abide by the Constitution to protect your people and fight for the nation's territorial rights. We challenge you to swear in front of the 98 million Filipinos so that the countless members of the Sultanate of SULU and the patriotic volunteers will not sacrifice their lives in vain. We want to remind you, Mr. President, that the Sultanate of SULU exercises sovereignty for over 400 years before the Philippines was colonized in 1521, or even before the Philippines was colonized in 1521. Isumpa mo yan sa mga 98 million Filipinos na mga boss mo. Magpakatotoo po kayo sa inyong sinasabi na kayo ang boss ko. Sana maramdaman namin sa kilos at gawa. We are asking all the Filipino people now to pray for the safety of our Muslim brothers, both in Malaysia and the Philippines, and to a peaceful resolution of the Sabah issue. Inshallah.